ओम नमः शिवाय स्टूडेंट्स स्टूडेंट्स वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग विद द प्ले द प्रपोजल बाय एंटन चेकोव एंड अंटिल नाउ वी हैव रेड दैट नतालिया एंड लोमोव दो हैविंग स्टार्टेड विद अ कॉर्डियल कन्वर्सेशन सून गेट्स इनटू हीटेड डिस्कशन विद द मैटर ऑफ ऑक्सन मेडोज एंड एज दे आर्ग्यू अबाउट द लैंड लोमोव फेल्ट अ पैल्पिटेशन एंड देन ओनली चुमुकोव एंटर्स द सीन नाउ स्टूडेंट्स वी विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट टुडे So you should have your book in front of you with a pencil in your hand so that you may jot down all the important points as we go through the same. So let's start. Enter Chubukov. What is the matter? What are you shouting for? Papa, please tell this gentleman who owns Oxen Meadows, we or he. Now Chubukov turns towards Lomov and says, Darling, the meadows are ours. So what happens, students? Okay, on hearing both of them fight, that is, Natalia and Lomov, Chubukov also enters to check upon them and asks what was the matter, why they were quarreling. Then Natalia asks her father to confirm the ownership of Oxen Meadows to Lomov. Chubukov definitely tells Lomov the same thing as Natalia, that the Oxen Meadows belong to them. Okay, but please, Stefanovich, how can they be yours? Do be a reasonable man. My aunt's grandmother gave the meadows for the temporary and free use of your grandfather's peasants. Underline the line, very important. The peasants used the land for 40 years and got accustomed to it as if it was their own. Then it happened that. So even you can see that Chubukov is not allowing Lomov to complete his dialogue also. He has already interrupted. Okay, whereas Chubukov is saying that how can you claim the ownership of Oxen Meadows because they are theirs, and he also asks Chubukov to be reasonable. He also continues his explaining his side of the story about how his grandmother's aunt's grandmother gave the few, all those things. Okay, but then only he is not even allowed to complete his dialogue and Chubukov has already interrupted him. Okay, excuse me, my precious. You forget just this, that the peasants did not pay your grandmother and all that because the meadows were in dispute and so on. And now everybody knows that they are ours. It means that you haven't seen the plan. So at this point, what happened, you know, Chubukov has already interrupted and corrects him. He is correcting him by mentioning that the only reason that the peasants got to use Oxen Meadows for free because it was a disputed land. But now everything has been settled and it is clear to all that the land belongs to the Chubukovs. It doesn't belong to the Lomovs. He also, that means Chubukov also at this point blames Lomov of not seeing the plan also. That the land, that everything has been settled and it belonged to them, not to Lomov. I will prove to you that they are mine. You won't prove it, my darling. I shall. So again, they are further quarreling. They are arguing, both of them. Whereas Lomov is insisting that he would prove them that the land belonged to them. Chubukov is also saying that you can't. Then also, Lomov insisted that he will. He will prove that. Dear one, why yell like that? You won't prove anything just by yelling. So just by shouting, you cannot prove anything. I don't want anything of yours and don't intend to give up what I have. Underline the line, very important. Why should I? And you know, my beloved, that if you propose to go on arguing about it, I would much sooner give the meadows to the peasants than to you there. So, than to you, that means why he has said so, that than to you, because he had already in his mind that boy, that Lomov, gentleman, was going to his son-in-law. So, from that point of view, he had said that he was thinking to gift or present meadows, Oxen Meadows to him. But he says that if you continue arguing with that, I will not give it to you. I am not going to make a present of it to you. Rather, I will give it to the peasants who are using the land. Okay. Then Lomov, I don't understand. How have you the right to give away somebody else's property? Definitely Lomov. Lomov also believes, no, that the land belongs to him. So he says he is not able to understand. You may take it that I know whether I have the right or not. Because, young man, I am not used to being spoken to you too in that tone of voice and so on. I, young man, am twice your age and ask you to speak to me without agitating yourself and all that. Underline the line, I am twice your age. So what is happening? That at that point, he is saying that Chubukov gets irritated when he is saying so by the tone, even by the tone in which Lomov chose to speak to him, because Lomov was talking to him, was speaking to me in a high tone. He was not soft spoken. He was not soft speaking. He was shouting. No, he was yelling. Chubukov has already mentioned. So he mentions that he is twice his age and deserves to be spoken with respect, politeness and all that. Despite that, Lomov was not at all talking to him, was not at all speaking to him in a polite tone. He was talking to him in a harsh tone, which was really very disrespectful. No, you just think I'm a fool and want to have me on. You call my land yours and then you want me to talk to you calmly and politely. How is that possible? You are saying that my land is yours, then also you are asking me to talk to you politely. Is that possible? Is that reasonable? Good neighbors don't behave like that. Stefan Stefanovich, you are not a neighbor, you are a grabber. So underline the line. So at that point, Lomov gets so much agitated. Lomov gets so much irritated that he says that you are not a neighbor, you are a grabber. That means you have grabbed my land. You are there to grab my land. Over there, Chubukov almost get irritated at his highest point, you know. So, what is that? What did you say? Papa, send the mowers out to the meadows at once. What did you say, sir? Oxen meadows are ours and I shall not give them up, shall not give them up, shall not give them up. So, both the daughter and father gets highly disrespected. Okay, by the way Lomov was speaking to him. Still unable to accept that what he just heard about himself, he asks Lomov to repeat his words. Then Natalia joins her father and says that whatever may be the case, that she is not going to give it up, because she claims to possess oxen meadows and refuses to let them go just because someone else is claiming it to be theirs. So there is no point of giving it to someone else, as someone else has come over there and claiming is that. Okay, we will see. I will have the matter taken to court and then I will show you. Okay, Lomov then threatens to take the matter to court and prove it to them that he is the real owner. To court? You can take it to court and all that. You can. I know you. You are just on the lookout for a chance to go to court and all that. You pettifogger, all your people were like that, all of them. So pettifogger means an inferior legal practitioner, especially one who deals with petty cases or employs dubious practices. That means who is not a honest one, who is dishonest. So at this point, when Chubukov, Lomov is saying that, he's threatening actually that he will be taking the matter to the court, then Chubukov accuses Lomov that he is just looking for a chance to go to court. Because and all his family members was simply like that. Whoever belonged to his family, they were all like that. He also insisted that he should go on with all the proceedings because he knows him. Lomov, never mind about my people. The Lomovs have all been honorable people. The Lomovs means whoever belonged to his family. And not one has ever been tried for embezzlement like your grandfather. So embezzlement means theft or misappropriation of funds placed in one's trust or belongings to one's employer. Yes, embezzlement means theft or misappropriation of funds placed in one's trust or belonging to one's employer. So over here, Lomov refuses to listen anything against his family and mentions that they are all respectable personalities, unlike Chubukov's grandfather who had been tried for embezzlement. Okay. Now, what is Chubukov saying? You Lomovs have that lunacy in your family, all of you. Okay, now lunacy is the state of being lunatic, insanity. Okay, now Chubukov mentions that all of the Lomovs, whoever belong to the family of Lomov, they are insane, they are irrational. Insanity and irrationality runs in the family. And Natalia is also joining his father. Natalia is also joining her father. All. Natalia is repeating after her father. Your grandfather was a drunkard. And your younger aunt, Natasha Milanova, ran away with an architect and so on. So there they are giving much more examples from their family, from the Lomov's family, who has been who has done something that does not suit a gentleman or a gentlewoman. Okay, so Chubukov calls Lomov's grandfather an alcohol addict, and he also breaks the news that Lomov's younger aunt has run away with an architect. Now Lomov is adding over here, your mother was humpbacked, but he is clutching at his heart because he has already excited, no? And he has the problem. He is saying your mother was humpbacked, but he's at the same time, what is happening, you see? Something pulling in my side, my head, help, water. Okay, but definitely Chubukov is not at all paying attention what is happening to Lomov. Rather, he is saying your father was a guzzling gambler. So both of them are throwing stones at each other, you can know. Okay, both of them are accusing each members of the family. Both of them are accusing members of each of the family. So over here, guzzling gambler means, guzzling means greedy, a gambler, a person who gambles or speculator. So as the blame is going on, Chubukov also calls Lomov's father a greedy gambler. Then, and there haven't been many backbiters to equal your aunt. So Natalia is also adding with that. My left foot has gone to sleep. You are an intriguer. Oh, my heart. And it is an open secret that before the last elections, you breathe, I can see stars. Where is my hat? Student, this is actually the dialogue of Lomov. He is saying that he complains actually that his foot is numb, and he calls Chubukov a plotter. He also says that he has pain in his heart. He adds that in the last election, Chubukov was. He is trying to say, but he could not complete his sentence as he feels dizzy. See, he is saying something, elections you bribe. He is trying to say something, but he couldn't complete his sentence because he was feeling dizzy at that point. I can see stars. That means he was feeling dizzy. He was not in his stage. He was not at all in a stable state. That's why he is saying that I can see stars. Where is my hat? He is asking for his hat. Natalia, it's low. It's dishonest. It is mean. Chubukov, you were just a malicious double-faced intriguer. Yes. So they kept on disrespecting him. They kept on accusing Lomov, both Chubukov and Natalia. Lomov, here is my hat. My heart, which way? Where is the door? Oh, I think I am dying. My foot is quite numb. So what happened? Lomov finally finds his hat and starts asking for direction towards the door. Because he is almost disrespected both the father and his daughter. Now with his heart pounding and foot numb, he feels that he is dying. Chubukov following him, and don't set foot in my house again. Take it to court, we will see. So what happened? Then also Chubukov and Natalia, they are saying that you go away and you should not come over here again. And Natalia is also adding to that you should take it to court, it doesn't matter. So then Lomov staggers out. Take it a point that Lomov is staggering out. That means Lomov is not in a stable condition that he will walk out of their house. He is staggering out. Staggering means when you are not able to walk properly, when you are trembling actually, that moment is called staggering. So we will end our class over here. In the next video, we will continue with the next portion. Till then, thank you. Om Namah Shivaya.